If Tom Crean could ask Tom Crean a question about the new season, about what's going on, what would Tom Crean be curious about Tom Crean?
With our season?
Yeah, or with you personally, or just this whole, you know, being more or less on the top of
the game. Wow, that's a stumper. I would say, do we have enough things going to make sure this team understands how consistent they've got to be, not just in their work ethic, not just in their play, but how consistent they have got to be to form the identity that we're going to have as a team. Are we going to be as consistent as we need to be defensively? Are we going to be as tough and physical as we need to be on the backboards? Are we going to learn from games last year where we weren't? And when we lost last year, it really sometimes came down to the physical play defensively, you know, and being able to keep people in front of us and get big rebounds. That's probably what I would ask. That's why I ask myself now.
My answer is
I'm highly confident that we can get there. But I'm not the one that's got to be physical.
Yeah.
I'm not the one. I know what I'm going to do consistently. I'm not the one that's got to be that way every day. And my job, our job, is to make sure that we have enough tools to bring that out in this team every day.
This has been a meteoric, almost overnight success story when you consider what you inherited 3 years ago.
I wish it felt like that, but...
I know. Well, if there are a couple of characteristics that you think help make that happen, what do you think they would be?
Oh, the fans. There's no question.
Really?
I mean, the energy. The fans. And it doesn't matter if it's somebody you meet at the gas station, somebody you meet stopping for something in another city. The emails and the letters, those are great, but it's the face-to-face, seeing people and knowing how much they care, and then the way the crowd support has been. There's no other... You know, I would say the in-house has been the day-to-day stick-to-itiveness. You know, in the day-to-day, we're not going to waver. We're not going to back off. We're not going to rationalize. We're going to keep moving. But there's no question that the underlying tone of this program is built on the energy of this fan base and how they did not let us crumble. Because if they don't come, I'm not sure these recruits come. If they're not here pouring passion into this program, I'm not sure that our players keep playing as hard and moving as hard and or doing all the things that they could do, even though we weren't having success. But the fans have driven the passion of this program to help everybody's be even greater that's in the program.
You return, I think, 4 starters, top 5 or 6 scorers from last year. Talk about what you see on the court happening this year in terms of building blocks from last year. So many firsts happened last year. And the good news is you have a lot to build on, but the scary part is these kids have to know they have to move forward.
Well, they've answered that. Last year they answered that. They moved forward. They didn't just beat Kentucky. Then they beat Ohio State, and then we got better. We were literally playing our best basketball at the end of the year, and that would have been something that you may not have looked at and said, okay, well, wow, they beat Kentucky and they beat Ohio State. I'm not sure you would have thought that. You go through peaks and valleys in a season, the ebbs and flows, however you want to view it. But you want to be consistent in how much better you're getting. And these guys did that. I think with that, they haven't skipped a beat in the offseason. We took about 10 days off. And other than that, I mean, as a team, we took 10 days off. I don't think there was one player that took 3 days off. But they were back at it. And I think that's what's really important. And we've had a very, very consistent spring and summer. Now it's got to turn into a consistency on the court. Not as much because there's expectations from the outside, but more because they wanna have an identity that they know they can really, really win with, whether it's home or on the road.
A couple more quick questions. When the name Cody Zeller comes up, what's the first thing that comes to mind?
Class. Just class person, class family. It's really, really easy to be a fan of his because he doesn't make it about himself. He's a great teammate. He's hungry. He's humble. And that's class.
Christian Watford.
Consistency has got to be the model for him. His whole thing, he's gotten better. Here's a kid that shot 32% from 3 as a sophomore, 44% from 3 as a junior. He's gotten better and better, but it's got to be consistent. And it's got to be consistent in all areas. And for him to be, there's not just one or two skills that he can hang his hat on and say, okay, this is good enough. He's got to have a multitude of skills, a multitude of tools, and he's got to do them consistently. And I think that's the biggest thing. And if he does that, he's going to have a great year, and we'll have a great year.
One last question. For people who don't know Tom Crean, for people, a lot of people are going to see you this year in a way they've never seen you before, simply because you're even more high profile with this program than maybe than ever. Maybe I'm speculating, but I think there's some truth in that. What can people, what should people know about Tom Crean? What don't they know about you? What kind of guy are you? I mean, now it's almost like you're scouting yourself. What would you say, if somebody had to describe Tom Crean in 30 seconds, and you're the expert, because it's you, what would you say?
Confident in what I'm doing, and who I'm doing it with, and what we're trying to do, but an extremely willing learner. And try to live with a growth mindset. There's no, hey, I figured this out, we figured that out. I mean, it's confident enough to know that, you know, we're doing things the right way, but it can always be done better.
And your MO for success?
I think it's consistency. That's your best form of toughness. Yeah, that's real toughness to me. Are you consistent? Is it really consistent with what you're doing, how you're coaching and how you're approaching? Not that it's always the same, but you're consistently trying to get the most out of something.
When I think of you, I think of quality person and the people around you. I thought, Emma, what would I answer this question if I were him? I would have said, it seems like every kid you go after, every person you have to surround yourself with, you know, you've really tried hard to surround yourself with good people. Is that fair?
Oh, no question. There's no question, and that was why it was the last rung for this program was to win, because we had the academics, we had the quality of person, the work ethic was coming, there's no question about that. We had all the people in place. We had a great university, a great boss in Fred Glass. I mean, our president, President McRobbie's excellent, fantastic staff. So again, yeah, I mean, I learned a long time ago that I really wanted to be better in everything. And the more you surround yourself with people that have those qualities, have the same desire to get better, but at the same time, they're pretty good at what they do, where you get energy from that, that's important.
I've always believed, and this could be wrong, obviously, I've always believed there are jobs that are made for people, people made for jobs. I've sort of believed this was made for you.
And I appreciate that.
Does it feel that way? Crazy to
I don't know if I'd say, I don't know. It's hard to look at it like that. I know this. If I didn't love Indiana and Indiana basketball, it would have been really, really hard the first couple of years here. Really hard. But even though I didn't grow up here, you love a program so much and you love what it stands for and you learn to love these fans and what they're all about. And that's what keeps it moving forward. And it was never about let's just tread water. It was about gaining traction and getting better. And that's exactly what we've tried to do.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Awesome.